Well, hello, everyone. Happy Monday to you. Glad you could join us for another TBC Connection. And it's been a little while since we've had one. We took last week off and trying to give as much attention to our graduates. Again, so we didn't cloud up your timeline or post so many things that you kind of got used to it and didn't really pay attention. We didn't want that to happen. So we took last week off. We'll come back this week. And what we will do is, since we are kind of moving back into in-person services, I want to continue to do these. Several of you have mentioned that you appreciate or enjoy these little devotional thoughts and things through the week, little connection points through the week. So what we'll do is we'll probably end up doing them Tuesdays and Thursdays. I know it's Monday now, so we'll do one today and then Tuesday and Thursday of this week, and we'll work toward doing them each Tuesday and Thursday, and just a check-in and, again, a bit of a devotional thought to continue us through the week. And hopefully, again, the Lord uses them as we work through just some scripture passages or different devotional thoughts throughout each one of these. Wanted to think about Proverbs chapter number 16. Now, last Sunday evening, just yesterday evening, we talked toward the graduates and really toward our entire church family from 1 Thessalonians chapter number 4 and the issue of our walk, how we ought to walk. And there's a measure in there, of course, of obedience. That is what really our walk is about, is how well are we obeying God's word, God's commands in our own life. And really what we tried to stress last evening is the importance of those things and how great it is to follow the Lord and the blessings that come as a result of that, and not living a life with regrets, making those wise decisions now, instead of in the heat of the moment or when we're faced with that temptation, making a poor choice and then suffering consequences as a result. Certainly we made the point that if we are saved, if we're a Christian, if we're a believer in Christ, then we are free from the condemnation of our sin ultimately, but that does not remove the consequence of our sin. And we want to make decisions in obedience to what God has given to us, so that we experience those blessings from the Lord. And blessings don't always come as something of a material sense. Oftentimes they are other things and other blessings that God brings. And sometimes even the peace of God and the strength of the Lord is a supreme blessing. And we need to understand that as such. So along with that thought, then Proverbs chapter number 16 and verse number 3, here's what the Bible says. Proverbs 16:3, commit thy works unto the Lord and thy thoughts shall be established. Commit thy works unto the Lord and thy thoughts shall be established. And recently I heard just an illustration from one of my favorite preachers, Dr. Bill Rice III, and he mentioned this verse in passing in speaking about the subject of obedience. But the way that he used the illustration was tremendous. And so I wanted to pass along to you and just kind of tie in with our service or our sermon last Sunday evening, just yesterday. What is it that helps us, and the illustration that he uses, what makes a horse valuable? But I want us to think in terms of what is it that helps us to experience the blessing of the Lord, or that helps us to walk in step with the Lord? What is it that is valuable to us? And we might say it that way. What is it that helps our children to be valuable, or something along those lines? And yes, we're made in God's image, and that alone is valuable. But is it our level of intelligence? Is that what makes us valuable? Is it because we're smarter than other people, and so that's why we trust in Christ? That's why we obey? Is it our smarts or our level of intelligence? Not necessarily, though that's a good thing to have. Is it our talent or our ability? Is that what allows us to be obedient to the Lord? Well, because we're intelligent, because we have certain talents or abilities, that what helps us to be obedient? No, not necessarily, though talents and abilities are great. They're wonderful to have, and we praise the Lord for those things. Is it even great training? Boy, well, they had good parents, they had a good upbringing, they had a good family life or a good home life, and because of the training that they received, maybe they went to a good college or those things, that is why they obey. Is that what it is? No, not necessarily. I think there's value in good training, and we would encourage our parents and grandparents and those that oversee children, boy, pour into them and train them. But is it great training? No, not really. What is it that makes us valuable or helps us in our walk? And the issue, again, is not intelligence. It's not our abilities or our talents. It's not in our great training. What it is it's in obedience. Are we willing to yield ourselves over to the Lord? And that is ultimately what makes us valuable, to be used by the Lord. It is that measure of our obedience. I can have all the training in the world. I can have gone to the best Bible school or the best college for my trade. I can have studied under the best professors. I can have read the best books. I can have had the best parents. All of those things might line up, but unless I'm being obedient to what is wise, the Lord's wisdom, really all that other stuff doesn't make much sense. It isn't valuable anymore to me. It is in my level of obedience. Will I, Proverbs 16:3, will I commit my works unto the Lord? Do you see that it begins with obedience there? Committing my works unto the Lord, and then what happens? Well, then my thoughts shall be established. If I will be obedient, if I will yield my works to God, then do you understand how He helps me to think rightly or think correctly about my life, my walk, what comes about in my day-to-day living? I need to commit those things to the Lord first. I need to be obedient to the Lord. And that helps me then to think correctly about my life and, again, about those situations in life. Do the right thing and you'll begin to think properly. And I think that's so great. We might even see it in the book of Ephesians where the Bible talks about children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. And then in verse number 4, it speaks about fathers provoking not to wrath, but bringing them up in the nurture and admonition of the Lord. The training part, the teaching part doesn't come until we have obedience, right? Because I can't teach a rebel anything. And if I'm rebelling against God's word, then I'm not really being teachable at all. I might be knowing things, but I'm not learning from them. And all of those things are just important. Now, I wanted to kind of tag that on to our thoughts from last evening and just think about, am I committing my works unto the Lord, my ways unto God, so that He establishes my thinking, my mindset toward those things? Am I being obedient? And so I hope that is a help to you. It has been to me, and I appreciate those thoughts that were passed along to me by way of a sermon illustration, and I wanted to pass those along to you as well. Hey, this is our first week where we'll have Wednesday services in person as well. We're going to continue to do as much as we can our live stream service. Thank you, those of you that have been able to watch that. But Wednesday service will be here in our building, 7 o'clock, and look forward to having folks here for that. Of course, Sunday services, we've been a couple of weeks now with Sunday morning and Sunday evening. And we're continuing to evaluate when would be the best to begin our Sunday school classes or evaluate what would be best in terms of service in that way. So if you'll pray for wisdom for us, we want to do the right thing and do the wise thing and what's best for everybody involved. So thank you for praying with us as well. Let's continue praying for one another. A lot of folks going through some difficult things, job losses and job prospects and just times of mourning and sorrow. So let's be praying for one another, even rejoicing with those that are having prayers answered and God is giving the blessing right now. We rejoice with those also. Can't wait to see you if you're able to be here Wednesday. If not, then looking forward to seeing you Sunday. That's, again, keep praying and caring for one another. Miss you, miss seeing you each and every day. Though we're able to be back in person services, I do miss kind of fellowship and time with church family. So miss you. I hope you have a great week this week. I'm praying for you and look forward to seeing you again tomorrow in our next TBC Connection.